So we have this game here, and we want to talk about what's called a Nash Equilibrium. So a Nash Equilibrium in a game refers to a result where neither player wants to unilaterally change strategies. So, a Nash equilibrium is an outcome where neither player, or no player if we had more than two players, where no player wants to unilaterally change strategy. So let's look at this game here. Do we have a Nash equilibrium in this game? And not all games will have a Nash equilibrium. So if we start here with Kmart playing low and Target playing middle, then will Kmart want to switch to middle? No, Kmart will not want to switch to middle because that would give it 0 rather than 2. If we start in this square, will Target want to switch to high? No, because that would give it 8 rather than 11. So this is a Nash equilibrium. What about down here? No, this isn't a Nash equilibrium. Either player would benefit by switching strategies. Likewise up here, this one's not a Nash equilibrium because both players would benefit by switching strategies because Target would rather get 11 than 8, and Kmart would also rather get 11 than 8. But this over here is another Nash equilibrium because if we start here in this corner, is Kmart going to want to switch to low? No, because then it would get 8 instead of 11. Is Target going to want to switch columns over to here? No, because then they would get 2 rather than 0. So a Nash equilibrium can be one equilibrium in a game, two equilibrium in a game, or none, or you know, any number. The most common place we see this is in what's called the prisoner's dilemma game. And I'm going to present some different numbers here because a lot of times people think that when we make the payoff sort of symmetric, that has something to do with what makes the prisoner's dilemma game what it is. So let me get my little model here. So in the context of oligopoly, the prisoner's dilemma most often comes up in the issue of whether or not a cartel, an agreement to restrict output and raise prices, can be sustained. So let's think about a situation where we have two firms. They can choose to cooperate with each other and collude in keeping prices high, or they can choose to cheat by competing and, you know, producing more and lowering prices and so on and so forth. And each firm has the choice of doing this and cooperate or cheat. Cheat is also sometimes called defect. Someone defects from the agreement. Or sometimes it's called being aggressive. And basically, what we're going to see here is that it's kind of stabbing the other person in the back. So let's suppose if they cooperate, firm A, the imaginatively named firm A, gets profits of 5, and firm B gets profits of 10. And if firm A stabs B in the back, so B is being a good or evil, I guess, depending on how you look at it, a cartel member and is being cooperative, but firm A stabs them in the back, then firm A steals market share from firm B and gets profits of 7 instead of 5, but this really hurts firm B, and firm B gets profits of 2. On the other hand, if firm A is a team player and firm B cheats on them, then firm A makes losses of 2 and firm B gets profits of 15. And if they both cheat on each other and compete really hard, then firm A gets no profits and firm B gets profits of 5. So notice, you know, this is not symmetric in this game. Firm B is generally better run, sort of like the target in our previous example here. So let's look at this game and try to figure out whether or not the firms have a dominant strategy or not. And they do, in fact, have the dominant strategy. And that's what's going to make this an example of what's called the prisoner's dilemma game. So you can see from these two firms' point of view, the best outcome is up here. They have combined payoffs of 15, and every other square has lesser combined payoffs. But this cooperation is going to be difficult to sustain, because if we start here, then firm A wants to get 7 instead of 5, and firm B wants to get 15 instead of 10. So it's going to be very hard to sustain that cooperation. And it's actually even worse than that, because if firm B is cheating on firm A actually does better by cheating in return. Instead of just sort of sitting back and taking it, they're going to compete back. So the prisoner's dilemma is a particular game where each player has a dominant strategy, and the dominant strategy is one that is to be aggressive towards the other player or to cheat on the other player, and it leads to an equilibrium that is worst, the worst possible outcome. And so there's lots of examples of this in, you know, over-harvesting natural resources, or, you know, can you trust someone to sublet your apartment or not, and, you know, prisoner's dilemma gets used lots and lots of places out there. So it's a common model in oligopoly, and how they can sustain cooperation gets to be very tricky. And we'll go ahead and talk about that perhaps in a class discussion.